Hey, welcome to today's vlog. And today majorly I'll be talking on public speaking, because I believe for everybody gets an opportunity at one point to stand on a stage and present. So there are some skills that you really need to master, understand, and put them to practice for you to be a good public speaker, for you to present what you want to present well. So on Instagram I did a short video where I was flipping a certain book that I've been reading over and over as I'm practicing on public speaking. The book is Public Speaking and Self-Building Self-Confidence and Public Speaking by Dale Carnegie. Yeah, he's also the author of How to Win Friends and Influence People, that I did a video in the playlist. You can check it concerning what the book talks about and other things. So the book is a continuous learning process which I'll be sharing maybe on a weekly basis, depending on what I learn. And so I was reading majorly on how do you get to remember things, how do you get to have a good memory. So in the book there are several examples given by former presidents of US, that's the Theodore Roosevelt and Abraham Lincoln. They have one thing in common, that they had a very, very sharp mind. They could remember people's names, could remember their speeches that they gave. They had a very good memory. But then most people don't know that they had an underlying strategy on developing a good memory of remembering things, practically everything. So the story goes like this. For the president, Theodore, the story goes like this, that there's this day that there were riots in the US, and there was also rainy season in that time. But then, he was an avid reader, of course. He took a novel and he went and sat outside under a tree. Surprisingly, he was so much into the book that he even didn't notice that it was raining, that it rained on him, as because he had so much concentration in understanding what was in the book. So as you can see, the first thing of remembering things easily is focus, concentration, getting your concentration right. Because in this modern age where there's so much distraction from practically everywhere, social media, friends, life itself, for you to develop a good memory, you need to create time where you have intense focus on what you are trying to understand or you're trying to read. And for Abraham Lincoln, is so surprising that when he was young, his teacher, he grew up in a very poor background. And in this background, where he went to learn how to speak, how to read and how to write, there was only one book in a class. So what the teacher could do, the teacher was reading the book to the children as they listened to the book. But maybe that made them to understand, because the book was only one, of course. So he had to read loud so that everybody could hear. So from there, Abraham Lincoln developed the habit of reading loud. Wherever he was, he could read very loud. So that, because he says in the book that time, the reason as to why he developed that habit, because he writes it was very important to him and resourceful, in the sense that he could remember things easily. Because when you read loud, basically, you are using more than one sense of your body. That is hearing by speaking loud and also speaking. So you have two senses, and even probably even could be three, because if you are reading a book, you're also looking at the book, you're seeing the words. So more than one sense, applying more than one sense of your body in trying to understand something improves the level of you remembering what you're trying to read. That's why we are advised, as we read, we take short notes, because now we are using our hands, we are using our eyes, and maybe we are listening to something, we also using our ears as well. So You can also develop that where you read aloud, take notes as you read, apply more than one sense of your body to improve on memory of what you're trying to read. So I guess by applying only those two basic principles of improving your memory, you have a better chance of improving and remembering things is one, as I said, improve on your concentration. You need to focus intensely on what you're trying to read and understand. Two, just like Abraham Lincoln, do read loud, use more than one sense of your body. Writing, read loud to listen to what you're trying to say, and also as you speak and see it as well. So finally I'm going to give a wrap-up of the three main key strategies of improving your memory that I'll be covering over time. One is impression. Impression basically, in the simplest term, is what you see. How does it impact the way you understand it? Take an instance of somebody tells you his name or her name. There's nothing unique about that person's impression in terms of maybe the complexity, in terms of maybe how they speak, the uniqueness. You might not remember the name clearly, but the impression of seeing the person, you will remember their face. Obvious, we all do remember people's faces, but then we tend to forget their names. So impression, we're talking more about that. Then there's the second one is repetition. Simple repetition. The more you repeat something, that's why you find kids when they start learning, they repeat the alphabet, the numbers over and over again by writing, by repeating, by singing, by drawing, everything. All strategies of execution and repeating improves your memory. Then finally the last one is as I've said, there's a associate impression. Then there is a repetition. Then there is an association. Association is like, if you're trying to remember something, for example, you're trying to remember somebody's name, whom can you relate with that person? Maybe you meet a friend and the friend introduces you to a new person who happens to be the cousin. So I think having the relationship, having the associating the friend to a cousin is more likely to stick in your mind rather than just being vague. That's why when we are young, we're told A for apple. Yeah, the association A for apple, they tend to stick because that's something visual that can easily remember it and can easily stick in our minds. So I hope the three takeaways that I'll be covering, and the first three that I've covered that you can execute right now and work on them, practice just 15 minutes, 10 minutes, because I'm a stronger believer in what Bruce Lee once said, that I don't fear a man who throws 1,000 punches or kicks rather in one day, but I fear a man who throws one kick in 1,000 days. Consistency and commitment, and all those will help you to build upon memory, because some of these things that we cover maybe in the school are very complex, but then if you can practice, build up these muscles of memory, then you have chances of grasping the content that you're trying to read, you're trying to understand in whatever level you are, or whatever thing that you want to be knowledgeable about, becomes a bit easier. I hope that's helpful. I hope that this YouTube channel is of value to you. Kindly don't forget to subscribe, and don't forget to follow me on Instagram as Okerosi Davis, LinkedIn as Okerosi Davis, TikTok as Okerosi, and on Facebook, follow me as Okerosi. Subscribe to the YouTube channel for the notifications of more value, because I believe you learn one nugget from one person, from one book, from one video, from one audio, and that's how we move forward. See you soon.